Hi guys, it's Kara, aka Ruby Velour, and this is Shiro, who's a naughty, naughty boy. Anyway, so today, doing something a little bit different, no Kara rage, rants, or anything like that. I'm actually going to talk about something very close to my heart, also known as Harry Potter. In case you didn't know, I am a huge Harry Potter fan. Have been since 2001, and I read the books, fell in love, not so fond of the movies, but huge fan. I mean, I've got two tattoos. It's a bit hard to see, but that's the dark mark. I've got Hogwarts crest on my leg, but I'm not going to balance on the chair for you. I'm sorry. So anyway, with great disappointment, I could not make the Australian exhibition of Harry Potter that's happening in Sydney at the moment. It ends this weekend. I'm not that organised. I'm kind of saving up to go overseas, so I kind of gave up on that. But a friend of mine went 2 weekends ago and she got me a few things, which I thought I'd share with you all right now. So, a few of the things she got. Sorry, Shira is knocking my stuff over. So I am a member of Pottermore and I got sorted into Hufflepuff. So, it's a bit of a laugh. She got me the Hufflepuff scarf. I hate Hufflepuff. But anyway, it's a cute scarf. I love it. Thank you, Cheryl. I also got, in this beautiful box, a Harry Potter pen, and I'll show it to you. Now, I'm not actually in this house either, but it was too cool to say no to, so that there is my Slytherin pen. Pretty neat, huh? It's really heavy too, so very cute. I am actually Gryffindor, but I don't like red, so that's kind of a problem. I like green better. Not evil though, I promise. Anyway, the last thing she got me, which really excited me, were Bertie, Bott's Every Flavour beans. Now, I know these have been released by Jelly Belly like 6 million times, so they're not that exciting. The last ones I had were the Bamboozled, which were, they'd give you all these different ones and there'd be two of the same colour, but each one would be a different flavour, like banana and pencil shading, so that was very exciting. But these are actually kind of more official, like actually from the books and the movies, because you can see there's all the flavors and there are some yummy ones like tutti frutti and banana and marshmallow, and then there are some really gross ones like booger and what else is there, black pepper and dirt, vomit, soap. So totally exciting. So I thought I'd share with you the experience of Bertie Bott's Every Flavour beans. I've actually eaten up pretty much all of the yummy ones because it's not much fun seeing someone react to cinnamon flavour, unless they don't like cinnamon, but I do, so yeah, I thought I'd show you, give you an idea what they taste like. Now, bear in mind, I'm not that opposed to gross things in my mouth, if you know what I mean. I actually find the whole experience really fun and charming, so I may not react as much as a normal person would when I eat grass-flavoured jelly bellies. And that's Shiro saying hello. So, let's start with this little guy is black pepper. Yeah, that tastes a lot like black pepper. Not hot though, that's alright. And the flavour goes away pretty quickly, so. Oh, except I think I accidentally ate a bogey one and it really didn't, it lasted a while, so I might pass that one. So yeah, black pepper, tastes like black pepper. Awesome. Let's try. Ew, not looking forward to this one. It's earwax flavour, so still got a really bad taste of black pepper in my mouth, but okay. Wow, if earwax tastes like this, I mean, my earwax from now on, man, that's nice. That's kind of fruity. Not nice, like not really nice, but yeah, if my bodily fluids taste like kind of sour fruit, it's fine. Next, let's see what we've got. Candy floss, boring. What do we have here? Marshmallow. Green apple. Okay. No, no, you're grass. Grass flavour. Okay, that's better. That's what this tastes like. Totally tastes like grass. Like, you know, when you're mowing the lawn and a little bit of grass gets in your mouth and it's like, oh, tastes like that. That's incredible. So yeah, these are totally awesome. Don't know why they don't just sell them, but whatever. Watermelon. Ugh, I actually don't like watermelon flavored things, so that's in the go away pile. Oh, we got banana. Nah, we know what banana tastes like. So this, I think, is earwax. So no, I've done earwax, haven't I? It's nice. Yeah. Sorry. Too many gross flavors. Dirt. All right, let's try dirt. Oh, okay. I'm not screaming, but that's gross. It tastes like I'm nipped someone's shoe. Lord. Okay, let's not do that one again. So now we're gonna pick off dirt. Oh, there's a sausage flavour. I don't have one. Oh, what a shame. Alright, what else we got? I think this is rotten egg. I'm not looking forward to this one either. Oh dear god. It doesn't taste like rotten eggs, but it tastes awful. Yeah. That's awful. So yeah, I missed out on like all the really cool flavours like earthworm, sausage, ooh, vomit. Okay, these are bad. I was totally hyping myself up saying I could do this, but vomit after rotten egg, that's disgusting. Anyway, that's my review of Bertie Bott's. Oh, banana. Oh, nothing tastes better either. Those little hard yellow bananas that like break your teeth when you're a kid. Tastes like them. Anyway, that's my review, and yeah, I hope you do better than I do. Maybe I'm not as brave as I thought I was when it comes to eating foul tasting lollies, but they're pretty cute. And I kind of feel like I'm Ron Weasley right now, you know, explaining to Harry what all the beans are about. So, fun times.